Hello children and viewers. So in the previous class we discussed about the what is rest, what is motion and what is distance and what is displacement. So now come to the what is average speed and what is average velocity. So what is the average speed and what is the average velocity? So I am going to explain. So now to explain the average speed, so let us consider, so this is a car. So this is a car started at A place, and now so this car is started from A and it want to reach place B, but it go from A place to B place, so it will be travel along a path, and this is the path followed by the car. So now this length of the path will be called as what? Distance. So now this length of the path will be called as distance, nothing but to go from A place to B place. Now consider, so this distance covered by this car will be considered, it will be the 700 meters. So now this total length of the path will be how much? 700 meter. So now to go from place A to place B to cover the 700 meter distance, now consider, so it will be take certain time, so that will be considered 20 minutes. To go from A place to B place, this car will be follow a path, so the length of the path is 700 meter. So to cover this length of the path, it will take the 20 minutes. So now if I divide this total distance by this total time, then you get the average speed. And what is the average speed? The average speed is nothing but it is a ratio between the total distance to total time taken. So what is the average speed? So the average speed, so the average speed is represented with the letter V, A, V, G, average. So the average speed is nothing but it is a ratio of total distance, covered by the body to total time taken to cover the distance. So total time taken. So now, so if I find the average speed. So what is the average speed? The average speed of the car is, what is the total distance? 700 meter. By what is the time? 20 minutes. And nothing but 00 cancel, when I cancel 00 and 21 are 23 are 25 are. And nothing but, so 35 meter for every 1 minute. And nothing but this car is travel for every minute. How much distance it is covered? 35 meter for every minute. When I convert it into second, so the second 35 meter by, so second 1 minute is equal to how many seconds? 60 seconds. 60 seconds, nothing but the average distance covered by the body is nothing but, so 7 by 12 is nothing but what? When I divide with 7 with 12, so when I put the decimal point 0 added, so 12 5 is 60 and 12 7 is 84. Okay, 12 5 is 60, so then you got 10 and 0 will be added. 12 8 is 96, again 4, so 12 3 and nothing but what is the average speed? 0.58 meter per second. So now this is the average speed of the car, and for every 1 second it is covered how much distance? 0.58 meter. Or for every one minute it cover how much distance? 35 meter. And nothing but the average speed gives that, so how fast or how slow the body will be moved. And nothing but when the body is traveling along this path, so for every 1 second it is travel 0.58 meter for every 1 second, or so for 1 minute 35 meter. And it is only an average, it does not travel exactly for every 1 second 0.58 meter and for every 1 minute 35 meter. So in 1 second it may it can be travel more distance or less distance, or in 1 minute it does not exactly travel 35 meter. It is an average, value. But nothing but by using this average speed, so you can guess, so how fast and how slow the body will be covered. So the average velocity is nothing but, so it is depend upon the displacement. So here the average speed is depend upon the distance, and the average will be depend upon the displacement. Average velocity is depend upon the displacement. So let us consider. So this is a car is travel along a straight line path. Along a straight line path. So now consider the car is started at A place and it will be reaches the B place along the straight line path. Along the straight line path. So now to go from the A place to B place, now consider. So it will be cover a displacement of 800 meters in 20 seconds. 800 meters in 20 seconds. And nothing but, so this car will be to go from A place to B place. It is travel along a straight line path. And nothing but it will be traveling a particular direction. So that's why it completed some displacement. So what is the displacement of the car here? The displacement of the car is 800 meters. And what is the time taken to complete this displacement? 20 seconds. So that's why the average velocity is nothing but, the average velocity is nothing but, so it is the ratio of the total displacement covered by the body to total time taken. Total displacement covered by the body to total time taken. So nothing but if we calculate the average velocity is also represented with the same letter, but we have to put the arrow mark here because it is a particular, it has a direction. So the average velocity is nothing but, it is a ratio of total displacement, nothing but 800 meter to total time taken, 20 second. And nothing but, so what is the average velocity of the car? The average velocity of the car is 40 meter per every 1 second. And it is an average. It does not exactly travel for every 1 second 40 meter. So that's why. So the average speed, SI, it will be the meter per second. And average velocity unit is also meter per second. The SI unit. The SI unit of average speed is meter per second, and the CGS unit of average speed is centimeter per second. And in the same way, so the average velocity, see SI unit, the SI unit of average velocity is also same meter per second, and the CGS unit of average velocity is centimeter per second. But remember, so the average speed is depend upon the distance and average velocity depend upon the displacement. But the displacement may be zero, due to that average velocity may be zero. But the distance never zero. That's why the average speed cannot be zero. Remember, the average velocity may be zero. Why? The displacement sometimes it may be zero, because when where it started again it will be returned to the same place. In that case the displacement becomes zero. That's why the average velocity is also zero. And nothing but the average speed never zero, but the average velocity may be zero. So the average speed has no direction, but the average velocity has a direction. It has a direction, it does not have the direction. It has a direction. So it may be zero. It cannot be zero. And why we have to calculate the average speed or average velocity? So with under nothing but to calculate the how fast the body is moving, how the slow the body will be moving. To that purpose, we have to calculate the average speed and average velocity. And next, coming to the instantaneous speed and instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous speed and instantaneous instantaneous speed. Instantaneous velocity. That is nothing but, so the speed of the body at a particular time or at a particular instant will be called as what? Instantaneous speed. That is nothing but the speed of the body at a particular instant of time. At a particular instant of time will be called as what? Instantaneous speed. Or it may be called as simple, it may be called as speed. It may be called as what? Speed. And nothing but the distance traveled by the body in 1 second. The distance traveled by the body in 1 second. But the time is the smallest time, generally we can use the 1 second. And nothing but the mean in the smallest time. What is the smallest time generally in our life? We can use in our daily life. 1 second. So that is the speed of the body at a particular instant time will be called as what? Instantaneous speed, or simply it can be called as speed. So the formula for instantaneous speed is nothing but the speed is equal, what is the formula? Distance by time. Distance by time. So generally the instantaneous speed can be measured with the help of the speedometer. Speedometer, generally the vehicle have the speedometer. Speedometer, so it will be in the circular shape. So there will be a scale. So like this, 0, 10, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So there will be like this, kilometer per hour. 100,000 or 100 kilometer per hour, and there will be a needle. So nothing but, for example, I want to calculate under when you are traveling with on a car or using a bicycle you are traveling. So you want to do, you want to find the what is the instantaneous speed at 12 o'clock 1 second or 12 o'clock 53 minutes 59th second. So then you have to look at the speedometer. So what is that indicate? What is the value that indicate? That will be called as what? Instantaneous speed. Instantaneous speed. The, for example, no 12 o'clock 53 minutes 59 seconds appudu enta speedo telavali vehicle oka vehicle velthunte. So appudu that can be measured with help of what? Speedometer. Speedometer. So the speedometer can be used to measure the speed of a vehicle at a particular instant of time. So now coming to the instantaneous velocity, and nothing but the velocity. So the velocity of body at a particular instant of time. At a particular instant of time. So again the formula for instantaneous velocity will be, so the velocity, instantaneous velocity, or it may be called as simple velocity. So the formula of it is the ratio of displacement to time. Displacement to time. So say what is S in it? Meter per second. Velocity, instantaneous velocity is also meter per second. The CJS unit will be centimeter per second. Here is also the CJS unit will be centimeter per second. But instantaneous velocity is nothing but when we get the instantaneous velocity, if the body is going along a straight line or along a particular direction, And for example, in case of the aeroplane will be traveling in a particular direction. So that's why the aeroplanes have the instantaneous velocities. Generally, the car, buses does not have the instantaneous velocity. When they have the instant velocity, if they have a along a particular direction or along the road which has the straight, then only they have the instantaneous velocity. And next coming to the uniform motion and non-uniform motion. Uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. non-uniform motion. So uniform and nothing but if the body cover equal distances in equal intervals of time, or if the body cover equal displacements in equal intervals of time, so then that motion of the body is said to be uniform motion. And for example, consider, so this is the path followed by the body, and nothing but this is considered, this is the path followed by the body. So now ఒక కార్ అనేది ఏ ప్లేస్ నుంచి బి ప్లేస్ కి వెళ్ళాలంటే పాత్ ఫాలో అవ్వాలి. అంటే వెన్ దట్ వెన్ దిస్ కార్ ఆర్ ఎనీ వెహికల్ ఇస్ ట్రావెలింగ్ అలాంగ్ దిస్ పాత్, సో నౌ కన్సిడర్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఈక్వల్ డిస్టెన్సెస్, దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఈక్వల్ డిస్టెన్సెస్. నౌ కన్సిడర్, సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద 20 మీటర్ అండ్ దీస్ ఆల్సో 20 మీటర్, ఆర్ లెట్ అస్ కన్సిడర్ దీస్ ఆర్ 100 మీటర్ డిస్టెన్స్ అండ్ దీస్ ఆల్సో 100 మీటర్ డిస్టెన్స్, దీస్ ఆల్సో 100 మీటర్ అండ్ దీస్ ఆల్సో 100 మీటర్ అండ్ దీస్ ఆల్సో 100 మీటర్. And nothing but what is the total length of the path? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And what is the total length of the path? The total distance or the total length of the path is how much? So 500 meter. But this 500 meter is I divide equally. Then this is called equal paths or equal distances. So if the body cover equal distances in equal intervals of time, equal intervals of time. And nothing but, so if the body cover first 100 meters in 1 second and next 100 meters is also in next 1 second and next 100 meter is also in 1 second, next is also 1 second, next is also 1 second, and what is happening? So this body is covering equal distances in equal intervals of time, equal intervals of time. So the equal intervals of time may be seconds or minutes or hours. What it may be, equal intervals of time, what it may be, but it must cover equal distance in equal intervals of time, then we say that the body is moving in the uniform motion. Okay, if the body cover equal distance, equal intervals of time, so now if we calculate the speed, so now what is the speed for in first second, this is the first second, this is second second, third second, fourth second, fifth second, and what is the total time taken? So the total time taken for the journey is how much? 5 seconds. 5 seconds. But in first 1 second, it covered how much distance? 100 meter. That's why what is the speed of this car? The speed of the car is 100 meter per second in first second. Because speed is nothing but distance by time. Distance by time. Distance is the 100 meter and time is the 1 second. So that's why what is the speed of the car in the first second? 100 meter per second. And what is the speed of the car in the next second? Next second is also 100 meter by 1 second, 100 meter per second. And next second is, in the third second is also 100 meter by 1 second. And next in the fourth second is also 100 meter by 1 second. In the fifth second is also 100 meter by 1 second. And nothing but when the body is cover equal distance in equal intervals of time, now which will be the same? The speed is constant. The speed is how much? Always the speed is the 100 meter per second. And nothing but the speed will be constant. And when the body is moving in the uniform motion, so the speed will be the constant. The speed will be the constant. That's why uniform motion is nothing but the motion, so in which the speed is constant. The speed is constant. As well as if we take the particular direction, then in that case, the velocity is also constant. Velocity is also constant. And nothing but if we take the speed, equal distance, equal intervals of time. If we take the displacement, now consider the body is covered along a straight line path. So now the straight line path, the total displacement is the 500 meter. Now you divided that displacement into equal part. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. So these are 100 meter and these are also 100 meter. 100 meter, 100 meter, 100 meter. But now in this time, the car is traveling or the vehicle is traveling along a straight line. When the car is traveling along a straight line, it is a straight line path. That's why these are called the displacements. These are called the displacement. What is the total displacement covered? The total displacement covered is how much? 500 meter. And what is the total time taken? Total time taken. Total time taken is how much? 5 seconds. Let us consider. This is the first second, this is the second second, third second, fourth second, fifth second. and in every 1 second the displacement of the body is how much? 100 meters. So that's why what is the velocity of the car at the first second? 100 meter per second, and next second is also 100 meter per second, and next second is also 100 meter per second, and the last second, fifth second, is also what is the 100 meter per second. And if the body cover equal displacements in equal intervals of time, then we say that the body is moving in the uniform motion. But when the body is moving in the uniform motion, the instantaneous speed equal to average speed. So the speed at a particular time will be called as what? Instantaneous speed. What is the instantaneous speed at the first second? 100 meter per second. At the second second, 100 meter per second. At third second, 100 meter per second. In this example, it is the same. And when the body is moving in the uniform motion, the instantaneous speed and average speed, and average velocity and instantaneous velocity will be the same. And what is the uniform motion? The uniform motion is nothing but if the body cover equal distances or displacement. Equal distances or displacements. Equal distance or displacements in equal intervals of time. Intervals of time, then we say that the body is moving in the uniform motion. So now when the body is moving in uniform motion, so if it cover equal distance in equal intervals of time, the speed is constant. If the body cover equal displacements in the equal intervals of time, the velocity will be constant. But if we calculate the average speed must be equal to the instantaneous speed. Instantaneous speed. In case of only uniform motion. But in case of uniform motion, the important thing is, so remember, uniform motion is the speed is constant or velocity is constant. Remember, so in case of the uniform motion, so the average speed, this is a very important point. So the average speed equal to instantaneous. Instantaneous speed, and as well as in uniform motion, so the average velocity is equal to instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity. Remember. So now this is about the uniform motion. Uniform motion. And it's coming to the non-uniform motion. And if the body cover unequal distances in equal intervals of time, or equal distances unequal intervals of time. So what is the non-uniform motion? If the body covers equal distances or displacements. Equal distance or displacements in unequal intervals of time. Unequal intervals of time. Or unequal distances in equal intervals of time. And now consider, so this is the path followed by the body. The path followed by the body, consider. So now consider, so it will be covered first 100 meters in 1 second, and next 100 meters in 2 second, and next 100 meters in again 2.5 second, and next 100 meters in 3 seconds, and next 100 meters in 1.5 second. Now what is happening? The equal distances, but it is covered in unequal intervals of time. So that's why, so the average speed cannot be equal to the instantaneous speed. So what is the speed at the first second? 100 meter per second, because distance by time. And what is the speed and next for 100 meters? So the speed will be the 100 meters by 2 second. And nothing but the speed is how much here? 50 meter per second. and the next 100 meters is covered in the 2 seconds. That's why speed will be decreases to 50 meter per second. But in the first second, it is covered with 100 meter per second. And next 100 meter will be covered in 2.5 seconds. Then what is the speed? The speed is nothing but 100 meters by 2.5 seconds. So 2.5 seconds, nothing but 1000 meter by 25 seconds. Nothing but 25 one ja, 25, so 4 ja. Nothing but 40 meter per second. And next 100 meter is covered with 40 meter per second. So first 100 meter is covered with 100 meter per second. Next the 50 meter per second and next the 40. And nothing but what is happening? So the speed changes. The speed change. And the non-uniform motion will be what happened? The speed cannot be changed. The speed cannot be constant. The speed will be changes. Remember, the speed changes. If we take the distance. And if it does not take the straight line path, so then it will be cover distances. In that case, the speed will be changes. And nothing but in the non-uniform motion, the speed will be changes. Speed cannot be constant. And next speed will be next, and the next 100 meter is covered in 3 seconds. And nothing but what is the speed? The speed for this 100 meter is 100 meter by 3 seconds. And nothing but 33.3 meter per second. And next 100 meter will be covered in 100 meter by 1.5 second and nothing but 1000 by 15. So 1000 by 15 means 15 6 and nothing but 66.6 meter per second. When the body is moving in the non-uniform motion, the speed cannot be same. The speed will be changes. The speed will be changes. That's why it is called the non-uniform motion. And if we take the displacement and if the body is moved along the straight line, along the straight line, now consider this path will be divided into equal parts. So this is consider first 100 meter and this is consider next 100 meter. So now consider the first 100 meter is covered in the 1 second and next will be covered in the 3 seconds, next 100 meter will be covered in the 4 seconds and next 100 meter will be covered in the 2 seconds and next 100 meter will be covered in the 5 seconds. And what is happening? So it is covering unequal displacements in unequal intervals of time. So that's why the velocity is different at different times. When the body is moving along a straight line path, so the body have the different velocities at different velocities. Different velocities for equal displacements. For equal displacement. So in the case of the first 100 meters displacement, what is the velocity? The velocity is 100 meter per second. And next 100 meter displacement will be covered with what speed? 33.3 meter per second. Because 100 by 3 gives us 33.3 meter per second. And next 100 meter displacement is covered with what velocity? So that is nothing but 25 meter per second. 100 by 4 gives the 25 meter per second. And next 100 meter will be covered in 50 meter per second. And next 100 meter will be covered in 20 meter per second. And nothing but what is happening? Even though the displacements are the same, but the time taken to cover the equal displacement is different. So that says the body is said to be in the non-uniform motion. In case of the non-uniform motion is also, the speed cannot be constant. The velocity cannot be constant. So the velocity will be changes. The velocity will be changes. This you have to remember. In case of the non-uniform motion, speed changes as well as the velocity changes. And in case of the uniform motion, the speed is constant as well as the velocity is constant. So in case of the uniform motion, the average speed may be equal to the instantaneous speed. In case of the uniform motion, the average velocity may be equal to the instantaneous velocity. So these about the uniform motion and non-uniform motion, average speed and average velocity, instantaneous speed and instant velocity.